No, we're just moving.
I started body casting when I was in the
And why the shape? What's so special about this?
What I've done with each of the images is I carved into the background and produced a very stylized musculature, because when you meet an athlete, you meet someone who has a certain structure and presence to them. and you're very aware of their bodies and structure of their bodies. So on each of these, I've carved in things that suggest the structure of the spine or the musculature, but it is very stylized. And then on the front, I ask each of them to identify what they consider to be their greatest sporting achievement. So for instance, this is Beth Fellow on the team, and she asked for me to draw an imagery to do with her 2009 World Cup. She won it in London. She said it was great to win in London in front of her friend of ours, which I'm hoping she can do very well in India. And on there, there are images of Beth.
And Chris, I think we'll see Chris.
Chris, no. Okay, Chris is fine. He is, as you imagine, everybody asks me what's he like. He is, as you imagine, he arrives full of energy, great enthusiasm, unfortunately, hairy body. I had asked everybody who I was casting to make sure that they'd shave before they came, at least a day before, because it can smart by now. And Chris arrived having just filmed the BBC before come dining with me and hadn't shaved, so he arrived very hairy and I gave him four pick razors, lots of foam, and he spent an hour shaving and then I had to finish off him over the beach. So that's on my CV.
Perfect, thank you. Thank you for doing that. Shaving for a second.
I know. It's funny, Debbie, because we was interviewed when I was in the exhibition, so London was there, and he was interviewed about it, and he said, oh, no, she's shaved all the way from her body, and you watched it, and it looked obscene, it sounded really obscene, and all I did was, like, a couple of bits and just missed, I said, it made him sound abstract and down. He was asking what Chris was like to work with. And they all went to the bottom in it. And based on that, they then changed the route, because with relays, you always run your strongest person up and the weakest person you've got the way up. So the British team actually changed their strategy based on that silver helmet medal. But they changed the order, so they ran the strongest one first. And then Chris was the weakest last. And actually, he said it's amazing because ordinarily what happened was, they'd set off, their weakest person was better than everybody else's weakest person, so they'd be that bit ahead and then that bit. And everybody else would lose faith. And the Americans were getting stronger and stronger. So they ran their fastest man, which Roger Blackley played their weakest man. Roger Blackley was way better than him. And he said they overtook, and he said they watched the Americans, and their heads went down. Because it's like, if that's the worst Brit, oh my God, what can they do? And he said, mentality was suddenly, oh, he might lose this. And he said, as soon as that went to bed,
the psyche changed.
And he said, in our psyche, and he said, in our psyche, it was like, yeah, we can do it. And they did. And he said, and that broke that dominance. So for him, winning that silver medal was really, really important.
What's
it made
out of?
Thank you. Take some time to go on here, please.